Thanks for sticking with us. I want to talk a little bit about the San Juan River. It's one of my favorite rivers. My river and all around the San Juan River since I was 80. And he's a geologist. So when he's looking at the rocks, I think about the eating techniques. And he thought about it early on, but after a while, I started thinking, besides just all of the plots on the sea for everyone, we can really see the ocean on the river and barrier events along the river banks. And I think there's almost no wall that seems to have ocean on. So I teach at Portland's College, which is a small private school. I teach engineering. I got something from some undergraduate students. And so in 2004, a few students, Jacqueline Lawrence, who really wanted to do a GIS-based project, she so they really should be cooperating with the rates. So I'm trying to look around this kind of person. So I have a couple of questions. My initial question was just what do you have the history of rationale and barrier on your similar mirror? Southeastern Utah specifically. So you're really good at supporting. Some idea of the core of the initial rationality region. Unfortunately, I couldn't quite do that. And then also, one of the characters of the state, not the stand, but inside, what's the stand, the size structure, and how the age structure is coming from, and what's the diversity of anybody else in the world? In the San Juan River watershed, it starts in Colorado. The San Juan Mountains flows down into the Mississippi River. Long ago, there was a very tiny history of our state area. And then it goes back up into southeastern Utah. And our study sites are more than a block. And then it flows downstream between the San Juan River Canyon, the Gooseneck. So I studied around the National Native Forest, and Jacqueline chose 3 feet of the sites. Most two of them upstream or downstream. And others for rationalists and are looking at two upstream. First site. This portion of the San Juan River is really a alluvial beach. We're not in a constrained stream, as what you see downstream. Looks kind of like this, although by the time you get really involved, some of the flowing walls, this airport is choosing just how much rationality it is. So let's look first at the history of rationality of attachment using this view of the people. And I want to look at the most respected in the study, but most of this work is in the city. She came at 1 3 political history. She talked about total reputation. Detailed changes in popularity around Bush and Wallace having particularly that's because until 2004 we call it changes. First of all, we started to build the bridge, which ultimately leads to more constrained channel. We have a reputation of the movie events. Now, 1980, a post-ban, the bridge is well established. The channel is stabilized. And the reputation is start to see here that the channel is now in 2009, I had to take this building, and the channel is now in the building, and it's not going in. So this is pretty different from the system we just talked about, it's like the opposite of the thing here, about these disturbance and this continued change, until 2009, we declined the reputation because of the fire mitigation project. So you might say, well, you know, the channel constraint is probably nothing to do with the bridge, and certainly not the wall. If you look at another one of our sites, the constraint of this bridge, the pots, you see the same problem. So we have 14 miles upstream. Again, in the 1950s, we were in a position of the wall, the invading the channel. So we have a picture of our channel. Not much change in the reputation of area events, but a decline in the reputation overall, probably due to the first So I mentioned Jacqueline was able to quantify the changes in the reputation we saw. It's pretty interesting. Across all three sites, we saw pretty similar patterns. With a big increase in the 1980s, increasing substantially in the 2000s, and then also sort of dropped in the mid-2000s, increased again in 2009, all dropped. So trailing, different pixels of different colors, and pixels of different vegetation types. We did run into some problems with this because different this imagery has color variations, and so it's not perfect. It's not perfect tool, but it did give us an idea of the changes in the ocean. Thank you. cottons to the best we can distinguish them. Which is mostly towns. I didn't separate those out of the school off. I didn't have a super high confidence. But I did have to track the cotton. Rationality did increase. I think it did increase my time really rock at sites 2 and 3. But site 1, I think it was not. Because one of the things that I really like is that it was defining the forest, but also rationality. So that decline of population after 2009 ages are attributed to a couple of different things. First of all, the town was arriving in the area in 2008 and the populations were increasing in 2009. I don't know if this could be discouraging to me. Okay, let's go with water and make sure it works with our boots. I'm going to make sure I'm skinned. I think I'm going to see it in the video. I'm going to just go with it. Okay. So, to identify four floodplain sites, and Jacqueline is looking at each of them from the site. Seeing the towns and waters in the creek and the rock water in San Juan River. Chosen name based on boxes, hopefully, could be happy to normal distribution. Each site has established four trains of the state of the next of the river, At this site, that's pretty defined by the site. And here, along those trains, that's going to be present. Caveat here, he didn't redevelop trees to dig around on the root farm, so we have to excavate this tree for 4 points. And these are going to be pretty distinct. So, stand structure, you can see the stands right there. We didn't show up, wouldn't it? It's surprising. There is a little bit of diversity, but I think that red stone rocks is really because of that. Okay, he was 10 years ago. Size structure was interesting. We did have a range of size classes. Different it's more of a multi area than like a size scale. Different than the area succession that's the relationship between the is remarkably strong. In fact, it's so strong that you're really noticeable. It's not on a huge sample size, it was 27 or something. So we did all the experiments and made sure that that relationship only exists across a wide range of sizes. But when that strong relationship allowed us to take a first stab at using this relationship to estimate ages of sizes of trees. So using construction models on the site, which range from 50 to 66 centimeters or millimeters. And this one has regression model added after the quality of these trees have been mirrored over maybe 40 to 43 years. And for that, in fact, it gives us establishment for the quality of the tree. And for that, it is interesting because not only the construction is seems to be a relationship there. So just to wrap things up, we have definitely seen changes in vegetation along the San Juan River. This is very important for the history of vegetation change for the landscape sequencing. You can see the top here of the rock has been reversed from the wet bare into the shallow. Vegetation cover increased, the channel became more and more stabilized over time. The initial increase really coincides with the potential of the environment. And estimated age of the restoration water, it's on approximately. So that may need a better loss of the disturbance. Shade tolerance or even successional tree species to know where you go like that. It used to be better than even successional species, almost now there's about 20,000 samples since the beginning of the year. Whereas there used to be, some models. So, kind of closing thoughts. The tamarisk leaf drop, it's clear, it's raw, it's clear, it's plant, it's really, so I used to think, oh, at least the rationality is extreme, it's equilibrium, it's not binary theory enough. It's very odd. The VR factors are binary, trying to stay with that and keep it on the limits. So, for your introduction, such an interesting pattern that the extension of the students who work so hard at the college, the Scotland, the DMT, here on the Rio Grande, little by little, the agencies in charge of the energy flows out of the dams and stuff, trying to create some kind of system that limits, you know, the flows that we used to see. Is there any of that happening on the Navajo?
Yeah, that's a good question. Yeah, I don't know all the details, but my impression is watching it street side and that's been problematic. What looks a little bit better than the same way it's in 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 the same way.
Is anybody looking at understory massive species or monophonics in the
Parks Service down in the National Recreation Area is doing a very screening and trying to. I think there's a whole lot of work going on in thank you. Yes, it's lunchtime. That's in ballroom E. We'll be starting at 1:35 sharp, so maybe in your neck of the room is about 1:30.